In fact, if I were the car, I might possibly be weeing myself right now. Because today it will be taking on Yves Rossy, the world's first jet-powered flying man.
Yves, I have many questions, starting with, what exactly is this thing?
That's a wing, and to push me in the air, four engines. It's very simple.
Four jets.
Yeah. And you steer just with your moves of arms and legs and...
So you haven't got, like, levers to control the...
Nothing. The only thing is a little throttle that I have here. That's the only thing that command.
Well, look, all the best. Mm-hmm. I'll be on the ground.
Yeah.
And that brings us neatly to the actual driving of the car.
Now, obviously, I could take the wheel of that thing myself and show that Swiss cuckoo clock some real talent. But under the Top Gear Apprentice Driver Training Scheme, I've agreed to let the guy behind me, Tony Gardemeister, cut his teeth on this one. To be fair, he's pretty good already. Finnish rally champion. Many, many world rally podiums to his name. But still keen to get some tips from me. So let's see how this race will work.
This is the course the car will be racing around. 8 miles of prime Welsh rally stage. As the car sets off, Yves will climb to 8,000 feet in a helicopter, jump out, and then follow the course from above.
Now, Rocket Man can travel at a steady 120 miles an hour, and we can't. Well, obviously, I could, but I'm not sure yet about our novice driver. Anyway, he might think because of his cruising speed, we don't stand a chance here, but there's more to it than that. You see, at the end of the race, Yves has to land, which means he has to cut his engines, deploy his parachute, and all sorts of technical Rocket Man stuff has to happen. So trust me, we're in with a shout here.
And also, we will be busy covering precious miles whilst his chopper is still climbing to launch height.
Just relax, Tony. I'm here if you need me. Obviously, Yves could cut a corner up there, but don't worry, we've thought of that. We have positioned a farmer out there with an air rifle, with strict orders to shoot him down if he sees any infringement. That's FIA rules, all sorted.
As the chopper lifted, the flag dropped.
We're off! Oh! He's quite confident. He's gone. What we're doing now is a bit. Yeah, just as you are.
20 seconds.
We are absolutely monster in this corner.
10 seconds to go.
We've got 265 bhp down here. Tony's using, I'd say, all of them. Yeah.
However, as we passed the 3 mile mark, Yves was ready to jump. Somewhere up there, he was following our course and closing the gap.
Hello.
Just concentrate.
Okay.
As a new driver, you get giddy, you show off, and it goes wrong.
Oh.
Speeds of 120, 150, 180 miles an hour in just stop in this. I mean, I'm just baggage now.
Within seconds, Yves had caught up.
I see the car. I see the car.
There he is. There he is. He's ahead of us. He is ahead. Ow.
As Yves streaked into the lead, we still had just under 4 miles to go. Up ahead, Yves' journey was, unfortunately, almost done.
Hammond has over the landing place to open. Here's the plan. Now we have to open.
There he is. There's his parachute.
He's going there.
He's behind the hill.
We are close. We are close.
We are. He's behind the trees. I don't know. He's not down yet. We still have a chance here. This is it. Where is he? Where is he? Is he there? Oh, no.
Did we last?
Oh, look at that. Don't blame yourself, that's the main thing, man. Don't blame yourself, come on. You did a great job.
Thanks from the guiding.
Yeah, I was happy.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm going to sit here for a little bit now, just...
But you look a little bit dark now.
Yeah, I'm just going to sit here for a minute.